Hello, it's Kat, and in today's quick tip, I just want to share one of my favorite workflow tips with you. When I'm working in Adobe Illustrator on a very detailed file, it can be really handy to see your work very zoomed in as you work on the details, but that makes it hard to see what the composition looks like overall. So what I like to do is go to my window menu, click New Window, and now you'll see that this file is open in two windows at the same time. And in order to view them side by side, we go back to the window menu, click on Arrange, Tile, and now we've got these two menus docked side by side. Now what I like to do is zoom way out on one of these windows, so maybe to around 25% so I can see the entire composition. And then on this window on the left is usually where I work on my details. So now I can feel free to zoom in and out and move different pieces. And if I move this blossom, you'll see that you can see it updating in real time in your other window. Another handy trick I like to do sometimes is hide edges in the window that's just my preview. So you can do that by clicking in the window that you want to hide the edges on and using Control H as your shortcut. And you'll still be able to see them in the window that you're editing, but now it's not getting in the way and crowding on the zoomed out version, so you can see what's going on a little bit better there. So if I move individual nodes, I can still see my changes in real time, and that can be really handy instead of turning edges on and off constantly in the window you're working in. One other trick I like to use here is in my preview zoomed out window, I'll go to the view menu and click on trim view. This way I'm previewing how the file will export on just the artboard, and then I can feel free to make changes in my working window, and I'll be able to see everything that's overlapping the artboard so I can move things around and get a quick preview of exactly how they're going to look trimmed without having to toggle back and forth between trim view. Last quick tip here, if you do want a smaller preview window, you can click and drag to rearrange how these windows are working, and you can zoom out even further on your preview window here and drag this over, and then just using your hand tool, you can recenter it there. So if you want a very small preview window and a large detail window to work in, that can be really handy as well. One thing to note here is that if you were to save the file right now and close it, when you reopen it, you'll get two windows again. They won't be docked side by side, but basically the document will remember that you have two windows open. So what I would do then is close my zoomed in view and then save my document like normal, and then it should open with just one window the next time I go to edit it. If you'd like to see how I created this cherry blossom graphic, I do have a whole tutorial on that. I will link it here for you, and if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.